our youth today, they're on a seesaw, so to speak. You can go this way and make something of yourself, but it's so much easier to go this way and be a statistic.
You want to ride the street life? You can't be in my house.
Concrete Cowboys is really a father-son story. A young kid who's raised by a single mom, estranged from his father, is basically dropped off on his father's doorstep in Philadelphia. And his father, Harp, is kind of a leader in this community of cowboys. And it's really about their quest to find a real relationship in the context of this like beautiful community that's really under threat.
Cole meets his father for the first time in a long time, and he's kind of angry with him because he hasn't been there. So he's having a hard time, you know, dealing with being separated from his mom and then being in this world that he's not used to, and then having to deal with a father that hasn't been there for him.
What is also great about this story is that we learn about fatherhood, Black fatherhood.
What you doing?
I'm out.
Al, where you going?
You're on my fucking business,
man. You ain't riding with Smush.
I'm riding with me. Like I done from day one.
Yo, man. Sit down, man. I'm your father.
You ain't my fucking father!
The thing I'd always tell Caleb when we were getting inside the head of Cole is your source of fuel is hatred. Like, you hear your dad's name, you think about your dad, it's just visceral.
It's very painful, but it's so common. There's so many kids who are young and lost and just want a father figure to guide them through life, but Cole doesn't have a real solid one.
Look, man, I got your back from here on out, all right? I'm all the family you're gonna need.
You know, sometimes you're thrown into the street life and you have no idea how you got there, but you're there because it feels safe. And Cole gets involved with that, especially with Smush. But at the same time, he's battling, do I just stay with my father, who has pure intentions?
Are you innocent or not, Cole?
But then no, my dad doesn't love me. So that's not fair. Smush shows me more love. So all of these conflicts for a 15-year-old boy is disastrous.
Why you hate me, man?
Harp, he's a guy that has a big heart, but he's caught in a cage of shame as a father. At a young age, he was doing illegal things, got locked up. It separated his family, it separated him from his son. And he's one of those guys who can connect with everyone around him except his own son.
He wants to do right after doing wrong. He's looking for his redemption, and a lot of that lays in his relationship with his son, Cole.
He doesn't know how to welcome or nurture this kid who looks like him. That's Harp's boy. But he ain't no cowboy. He's not part of this community, and he doesn't even want to be.
Cole wants to love him, but he's still angry at him for not being there. And then once he feels that his dad has the chance to love him, he doesn't show his love, and he doesn't realize that Harp doesn't really know how to.
Harp has never really developed into a father. So just as much as it's a coming of age story for Cole, it's like a coming of fatherhood for Harp.
You hurt?
There's a scene after Smush has died and he's cleaning coal and, you know, puts new clothes on him. I wanted it to look and feel like what it's like when I give my 2.5-year-old a bath and I change him. It's tender and it's beautiful. It's like he finally learns how to be vulnerable.
Harp had complexities that we ended up bearing on the screen. Harp in the film, he cries openly in front of his son, but, you know, he hasn't done that for a long time.
A lot of beautiful things, a lot of painful things come out of the presence or absence of a father. So I think what's amazing about this story is it explores both.
And what this does is it sort of dispels the notion that African-American fathers are not involved with their kids' lives.
I think it's an important story to tell just to see that relationship. We see it all the time with white people. We see it with Latinos, but a lot of times, Black fathers don't get the credit that they deserve, and we are present, even more now than we were before. So we're putting a lens on it and focusing in and letting you guys come in and see what it is.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.